you're watching.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Rajasthan is well known around the world for its vibrant culture and its colorful way of life. Ranked among top tourist attraction in the nation, the state has a variety of places and festivals to please the eyes and soothe the soul of an individual. The annual fair, organized in Pushkar, is world's largest cattle fair and attracts a number of visitors from India and abroad. This year, the Pushkar fair was inaugurated with great pomp and show to welcome devotees, cattle traders and visitors to be a part of the festival.
The Pushkar fair is organized every year for 5 days. It starts from Ekadashi and ends at the full moon night of the month of Kartik according to the Hindu calendar. The grand event has activities, competitions, cultural programs and musical events that showcase the magnificence of Rajasthani culture.
काफी अच्छा वातावरण है बहुत लोगों में उत्साह है और जोश है और 4000 से ज्यादा अभी तक पशु आ चुके हैं और जो सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम और जो दूसरे इवेंट्स होने हैं वो भी काफी अच्छा कराए जाने की कोशिश की जा रही है और ये भी ध्यान रखा जा रहा है कि जो भी दर्शनार्थी और इसमें जो भी लोग आते हैं जो शरीक होते हैं उनको किसी तरह की कोई परेशानी नहीं हो.
This year, the fair was inaugurated by the district collector after offering the ceremonial prayers, followed by hoisting of the national flag. The main attraction of the inaugural ceremony was a traditional and colorful dance performance by little girls.
इस बार हमने सरोवर पूजन के साथ जो है मेले का शुभारंभ किया है और जो कल्चरल इवेंट्स होने वाले हैं उसमें भी बहुत अच्छे अच्छे कलाकारों को जैसे कैलाश खेर को बुलाया जा रहा है और जो पशु मेले में जो पशु आए हैं उनके स्वास्थ्य की ध्यान और उनके पशु पालकों के लिए भी अच्छी व्यवस्था की गई है और उम्मीद करता हूँ कि मेला जो है बहुत ही अच्छा होगा और इसमें सभी लोग जो भी आएंगे किसी तरह की कोई परेशानी नहीं होगी.
Mesmerized by the drum beats played by international drummer Nathuram Solanki and his fellow drummers and musicians, the visitors were seen dancing to the Rajasthani folk tunes. Visitors were also seen enjoying a fun-filled football game.
Very good, very exciting. Lots of people. Lots of noise. Yeah, great. Loving it. Yeah, very different. Yeah.
Exotic. Huh? It's a big bazaar. And it's a what? Very nice.
The most celebrated events include the famous horse dance competition and the hot air balloon race. Apart from being culturally and traditionally important to people, the fair also holds religious importance as devotees from far come here on these auspicious days to worship Lord Brahma and take a dip in the Pushkar Sarovar.
It's been said that food knows no barriers and boundaries. For years, the exchange of food among states and people has played a major role in the exchange of culture, habits and values. Dilshad Khan in Chandigarh has been serving the traditional Punjabi dish of Rajma Chawal to people regardless of caste, community or religion, and has been giving the message that food unites us all. Take a look.
Owner of Khan Rajma Chawal, Dilshad Khan serves authentic Punjabi dishes like rajma and curry rice in his stall on the streets of Chandigarh, setting an example of communal harmony between different communities and religions. Dilshad's food and services are admired by many people.
मैं जब भी यहां आता हूं इनके पास खान साहब के पास वहां लंच इनके पास करके जाता हूं इतने थोड़े से पैसे से जो लोगों का पेट भरते हैं और आपने देखा होगा यहां सभी धर्मों के लोग मैं एज ए सिख कोई हिंदू होगा कोई मुस्लिम होगा कोई पंडित होगा कोई क्रिश्चियन होगा सभी को ये इतने थोड़े से पैसे से ये खाना खिलाते हैं मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है देखो एक ये एग्जांपल है भारत में भी ये मुस्लिम हैं लेकिन सभी धर्मों के पास इनके पास खाना खाने आते हैं
At a mere price of rupees 30, Dilshad feeds his customers with both the dishes. Dilshad's customers praises him for his calm and friendly nature, along with his good organizational skills, like the idea of serving orders according to the token numbers.
It's not only the food, it's the ambience, it's the thing that they provide, it's the services also. So I consider, see, everything is in line. You first take the token and then he has managed. So I'll tell you, there is management, there is ethics, there is taste, and there is no ambience out here. So that's why we come and we enjoy. Today our friends are absent, or else a group of four or five students, we come and then we enjoy this. We are regular.
Without any discrimination, people of all creeds, religion, caste, profession, age and gender come here and enjoy their meals. Dilshad's Rajma Chawal continues to be favorite spot for many in Chandigarh for his food, hygiene and warmth, but most importantly for the message he delivers.
कोई भी मजहब या कोई भी धर्म लड़ना तो नहीं सिखाता हर धर्म का जो है काम आपस में जोड़ना ही होता है धर्म का नाम धर्म जोड़ने का नाम है तोड़ने का नाम नहीं है और यहाँ चंडीगढ़ में हमने खास करके बात देखी कोई किसी का रिलीजन से कोई मतलब नहीं है और ना इस बात से किसी को परेशानी होती है और कभी हमने तो यहाँ तक देखा कि हम इतने साल हो गए हमें कि हमें किसी का नाम पूछने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती या कोई हमसे हमारा नाम भी नहीं पूछता कि उससे इतना ही बहुत है कि हाँ ये ठीक है तो बस ठीक है तो यहाँ पे माशाल्लाह बहुत बढ़िया है
India has always had many examples of how different people live together in harmony, and Dilshad is one of them.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
China joined 14 countries on agreeing terms for what could be the world's biggest trade pact. But India pulled out at the last minute on the grounds that the deal would hurt its farmers, businesses, workers and consumers.
India conveyed its decision at the summit not to join the RCEP agreement. This reflects both our assessment of the current global situation as well as of the fairness and balance of the agreement. India had significant issues of core interest that remained unresolved.
The Sino-US trade war and rising protectionism have given new impetus to years of negotiations on the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, which brings together the 10-member Association of Southeast Asian Nations, ASEAN, China, Japan, South Korea, Australia and New Zealand. Members said the deal would be signed next year after the 15 countries without India reached agreement in Bangkok on the text and market access issues.
India has participated in good faith in the RCEP discussions and has negotiated hard with a clear-eyed view of our interests. In the given circumstances, we believe that not joining the agreement is the right decision. For India. We would continue to persevere in strengthening our trade, investment and people-to-people relations with this region.
Member nations opened the door to India potentially joining them later if the issues it has with the deal are resolved. India has been worried that the agreement, which requires the gradual elimination of tariffs, would open its markets to a flood of cheap Chinese goods and agricultural produce from Australia and New Zealand that would harm local producers. Indian Defence Minister Rajnath Singh and his Russian counterpart Sergei Shoigu chaired the 19th India-Russia Intergovernmental Commission and Military Technical Commission meeting in Moscow. Our partnership with Russia will give a major boost to Make India initiative. Received strong support from Defence Minister Shoigu for DEF Expo India 2020. I also welcome the strong Russian support for early operationalization of Kalashnikov joint venture, Singh said in a tweet. Following the talks, the visiting delegation presented Shoigu with a silver bowl having Indian and Russian flags as a mark of friendship between the armies of the two countries. India and Russia enjoy friendly relations in energy, defense, and various other sectors.
Moving on, Japan is leaving no stone unturned to give a boost to its tourism sector. Recently, Yokohama City hosted a grand music festival with much grandeur. On the other side, Japanese company Nisei has introduced a new flavor of soft ice cream to satiate the taste buds of tourists. A report.
The song Blue Light Yokohama has been popular since long time for describing the charm of Yokohama City. The city of Yokohama hosts city-wide music festival called Yokohama Oto Matsuri, and this is one of 300 musical projects from this big festival which lasts for 62 days. The festival takes place every 3 years in various locations in Yokohama, inviting a wide range of musicians from local music groups to worldwide well-known artists. On this day, both amateurs and professional musicians of all genres performed a special set inside one of the prominent shopping malls in Yokohama.
This
performance is by a local gospel choir group, YCC Gospel Lovers. From a quiet song with a beautiful voice, pop music with dance fascinates the audience. Their energetic performance grabs attention across the mall. This day's last act is delivered by a Japanese pop and comedy duo, Le Romanesque. In special show, singing and dancing with Japanese traditional song Enka, the audience applauded the collaboration song with Pops and Enka.
Yokohama ってやっぱり文化的に豊かな街なのかなというふうな印象もありますし、演歌との融合みたいな一番遠いようで、まあなんか大衆音楽としてすごくつながれるんじゃないかなと思って、良い感じにマッチングしたんじゃないかなと思っています。
Yokohama has many cultures of port town history. Events that consider merging with towns create new culture.Music of Yokohama Oto Matsuri flowing along the town gives visitors a good time. This soft ice cream is winner at Grand Prix Ice Cream in Yokkaido. This area is Cape Soya, the northernmost steep of Japan. Hokkaido is located in north of Japan.Foreign tourists are increasing to enjoy the charm of nature and food in Hokkaido. Award-winning soft ice cream is sold near this northernmost area. At Firm Restaurant in Toyotomi Town, many visitors come having good time and eating milk food and sweets during lunchtime. Milk ramen and soup is arranged with milk. Most popular sweet is soft ice cream. Many repeaters are happy to eat soft ice cream.
トヨトミ町の牛乳を使っていまして、牛乳の味そのものっていうか、コクがあるんですけど、後味がさっぱりしているソフトクリームを作りました。The
main industry in Toyotomi Town is dairy farming, and the vast area used for it is mostly a cattle ranch. Cows can eat pasture all year round in this ranch. Soft ice cream milk of Fern Restaurant is taken from cows at the Shirata farm. Dairy technical intern from Asia is studying dairy skills and working on a ranch. She is from Vietnam.
Khi mà sữa mình vắt ra xong làm thành kem thì mọi người ăn cảm thấy rất là vui. Rất là ngon nên cảm thấy rất là vui.
Taste of soft ice cream has milk, chocolate, and seasonal flavors. During this autumn season, shop adds grape-flavored soft ice cream to menu.
この豊富町がまあ酪農の町だということも含めまして、まあ牛乳をメインとした料理になりますけども、まず一番のメインは豊富牛乳を使ったソフトクリーム。これ味決定するまでには結構試行錯誤しながら決めたんですけど、濃くなくというかくどくなく、食べ終わった後にもう一個食べれるような、食べに来たいねっていうようなソフトクリームの味にしたいな。外国と比べるとやっぱり日本のソフトクリームは多分美味しいと思うんですけど、その中でもやっぱり北海道のソフトクリーム、その中でもこの豊富のソフトクリームは美味しいって多分感じるとは思います。
Soft ice cream made from milk of cow grown healthy in nature is expected to be Japanese sweets to make enjoy international travelers.
In India, animals, birds, and all other living creatures hold a special significance among Hindus and other religious communities. Sacred to Hindu community, cows are revered as Kamdhenu or goddess of plenty according to Hindu scriptures. Beholding these beliefs of Hindu community and generosity towards all animals, many zoophilists from different religious backgrounds have raised an organization in Bareilly district of Uttar Pradesh in India with an aim to rescue and rehabilitate stray cows and other creatures in their locality. Take a look.
Animals cannot voice their pain and misery in words comprehensible to humans. But humans have this inherent ability to understand these creatures. Such is the thinking of Shabir and her madam Shalini Arora, who runs an organization in Bareilly district of Uttar Pradesh that rescues abandoned cows, dogs and different stray animals, providing them love and care these voiceless animals seek from humanity.
और इंसान के लिए हम काम करते हैं, कोई गौ माता कोई परेशानी वाली बात नहीं है, मुसलमान या हिंदू के इसमें कोई बात नहीं है, धर्म कभी आता ही नहीं है हम लोगों के बीच में, और मैं भी कोई परेश नहीं करती है, सब गौ वंश को हम साथ में करते हैं और कोई ऐसी बात नहीं है, सेवा करते हैं गौ की, कोई बात नहीं है, इससे कोई परेशानी नहीं है।
Sabir, who is a Muslim by religion, undertakes care of cows in the organization. The other animal lovers working with Sabir often praise him for his commitment towards rehabilitation of cows, which are sacred animals to Hindu community.
Sabir बहुत पूरे मन से काम करता है, कोई ऐसा फर्क नहीं आता कि वो मुसलमान है और हमारे साथ काम कर रहा है और गौ सेवा कर रहा है यहाँ पे. देखा जाता है ज़्यादातर कि गौ सेवा केवल हिंदू लोग ही करते हैं, गौ आश्रम में हिंदू लोग ही सेवा करते हैं और वहाँ पे जो भी गाय की देखभाल करते हैं हिंदू लोग ही करते हैं, पर ऐसा नहीं है. साबिर हमारे लिए नहीं देश के लिए एक मिसाल है कि यहाँ पे गौ सेवा के लिए साबिर दिन रात हाजिर रहता है। अगर हम रात को भी बुलाते रात को भी साबिर हमारे साथ रहता है। और हमारे जो तौफिक भाई हैं, अगर हम रेस्क्यू के लिए उनको कभी कॉल करते वो कभी मना नहीं करते। और ख़ास तौर से गाय के लिए, अगर हम उनको बोलते हैं गाय या कोई जानवर के लिए हमको चाहिए आपकी हेल्प, तो अपना जो भी काम होता है उसको छोड़ के आते हैं और बिना पैसे के यहाँ पे हमारी मदद करते हैं।
Upholding humanity towards animals above all the religious differences, the head of this organization, Shalini Arora, has rescued over 70 animals with the help of dedicated humans like Sabir and Tawfiq.
इंसानियत का कोई मज़हब नहीं होता और जो काम हम लोग कर रहे हैं वो टोटली इंसानियत से ही जुड़ा हुआ है कि हमारे अंदर नॉर्मल लोगों से ज़्यादा संवेदनशील हम लोग होते हैं जो एनिमल लवर्स होते हैं। और चूंकि इंसानियत का कोई धर्म नहीं होता है इसलिए हिंदू मुस्लिम का भेदभाव हमारे अंदर कभी नहीं आया।
द शेल्टर होम रेज फॉर एनिमल्स इन बरेली हाउसेस डॉग्स कैट्स काउस मंकीज बर्ड्स एंड मेनी अदर क्रीचर्स। द एनिमल लवर्स वर्किंग विद दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कम फ्रॉम डिफरेंट रिलीजियस बैकग्राउंड्स एंड कीप ह्यूमैनिटी अबव ऑल रिलीजियंस एज देयर मंत्रा।
In a first-of-its-kind record, Maryam Khan and her team of 30 women have been successful in creating world's largest mosaic through nails. Based in the city of Indore, Madhya Pradesh, the artwork is an amalgamation of various themes that portray human behavior and its tendencies. After a lot of diligence and hard work, these women have created this masterpiece. Have a look.
Indore-based artist Maryam Khan decided to create a mosaic using 20 lakh nails that stands out among other artwork. With a team of 30 women artists from different places, the record artwork was completed in a span of 10 long months.
This is the world's largest mosaic. इसके पीछे बहुत सारी स्टोरीज़ हैं। इसकी शुरुआत इस तरीके से हुई कि मेरे हस्बैंड ने जो है इसका ये थॉट इनकी है और इन्होंने जब ये थॉट आई तब मुझसे डिस्कस की इस बात को, तो हम लोगों को बहुत ही अच्छा कंसेप्ट लगा ये और हम लोगों ने जो है इसको सोचा कि वुमेंस के साथ इसको शुरू किया जाए। अभी तक हमने ये काम नहीं किया था, ये पहली दफ़ा किया है। 30 गर्ल्स हैं इसमें, 30 गर्ल्स हैं मेरे साथ, उन सब ने जो है इसमें 13 से 14 घंटा काम कर हमने इसको बनाया है। और इसमें पूरा जो है इसकी जो शुरुआत हुई थी 10 महीने पहले से हुई थी, 10 महीने में ये आर्ट पूरा तैयार हुआ है।
Trying to give a brief about the artwork, Maryam says that various themes like World War II, human nature and psychology have been included in this piece. Each element like the upside down brain and heart and the world map on the wheel have a deep meaning and all the elements have been carefully designed and crafted.
इस आर्ट के बारे में बताऊंगी कि इसमें दोनों तरह की चीज़ें बताई हैं, रियलिज्म भी बताया है और एब्स्ट्रैक्ट भी बताया है। तो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट में जो फेस देख रहे हैं आप, उसमें जो तीन होल्स हैं वो बताते हैं कि जो एक इंसान का दिमाग है वो सोचता बहुत ज़्यादा है, समझता कम है, और जब काम करने की बारी आती है, जब एफर्ट्स देने की बारी आती है तो और भी कम हो जाते हैं। उसके आगे हमने ये दिमाग और दिल दोनों के बीच में एक लैडर बनाई है जो कि इनकम्प्लीट है, क्योंकि दिमाग और दिल की सोच कभी मतलब एक जैसा नहीं सोच पाते हैं।
An embodiment of women's strength, the artwork successfully portrays the story of women, which is told by women themselves.
इसमें जो है हम दो मेल्स आपको नज़र आएंगे टॉप में जब आप देखेंगे, जिनके हमने फेसेस नहीं बनाए हैं। एक्चुअली उसका रीज़न ये, मेल्स जो हैं वो सिर्फ ऑर्डर करना जानते हैं, एक चीज़। दूसरी चीज़, हमने पीछे एक लेडी बनाई है जो कि वो एक गाड़ी में बैठकर जा रही हैं। देखिए, वर्ल्ड वॉर टू को हमें दिखाने का ये मकसद है, हम वुमेंस पावर दिखाना चाहते हैं। और इसमें जो है, जब भी कोई दुनिया में वॉर हुई है, सबसे ज़्यादा नुकसान जो है वुमन का ही हुआ है।
Maryam's husband Wajid Khan has played a major role in completion of this artwork by training these women for a month after assembling of the team. He hopes that many men in India
bring out the best in the women around them and be a part of their success story. That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at suggest.myindia@gmail.com. I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
You're watching Tag.